हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 8, वेलकम टू डीएवी मॉडल पब्लिक स्कूल। आई एम योर सोशल साइंस टीचर नितिन पुष्पतुड़े। टुडे आई विल टेक द रिवीजन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज यूटिलाइजेशन एंड डेवलपमेंट पार्ट फर्स्ट। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर टुडेज ऑनलाइन सेशन। यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, नेचर हैज प्रोवाइडेड टू अस अ लार्ज वैरायटी ऑफ रॉक्स, सॉइल्स, मिनरल्स, वेजिटेशन, एनिमल्स एटसेट्रा। वी यूज दिस गिफ्ट्स ऑफ नेचर to fulfill our day-to-day needs. Students, resources, utilization of resources depends on many factors. We need, require some most important things for the proper utilization of resources. Students, resources become usable when they are processed. For example, cotton is converted into yarn. On further processing, it is converted into fabric, then finally into garments. That means, students, at various stage value addition is possible by applying skill and technology. Okay students, the first picture depicts the message about the agriculture resource. Yes, for doing agriculture some labors are required. Students, some skilled and unskilled human beings are important for the agriculture. So students, agriculture resource depends on skilled and unskilled labor and again the technology also. Okay students, generally the utilization of resource depends upon the various factors such as availability of resources, skill of human beings, availability of capital, availability of water, advancement of technology, availability of transport and communication. In the initial stages of economic development, availability of resource played a very important role in the development of resources. Students, with the advancement of technology, availability of capital and skilled labor became the necessity for the utilization of resources. Yes, definitely students, without these factors, we can't utilize the resource as properly and effective way. So that's why students, we need technology, we need capital, we need water, we need transport and communication and the other things for the proper utilization of resources. Students, in a developed countries, a well economically developed and technologically advanced situations are there. So that's why they utilize resources in a proper manner. Students, on the other hand, India is still in a developing stage. So that's why in our country, there is less things. For example, advancement of technology and again the advancement in communication and transport sector. So that's why in our country utilization of resources is going on in a limited manner as compared to the developed country. But still students, we develop that all to all entire factors for the utilization of resources properly. Next point is classification of resources. Okay students, on the basis of different factors, resources are classified into many types. Then first, on the basis of renewability, resources are classified into two types, renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Okay, first, renewable resources. Students, resources which can be renewed either naturally or by human efforts are known as renewable resources. Renewable resources are also known as inexhaustible resources. Students, for example, solar energy, air and water, these are the example of renewable resources. Some of the renewable resources are always available and don't get completely emptied by the human activities, for example solar and wind energy. Okay students, second type, non-renewable resources. Resources which take millions of years to form or renew are known as non-renewable resources. That means students, resources take millions of years to form or renew, they call the non-renewable resources. They are also known as exhaustible resources as they cannot be renewed. Students, yes, some resources which cannot be renewed, they are also called the non-renewable resources. Students, energy resources such as coal, petroleum, natural gas and other minerals are the example of non-renewable resources. Students, they are available in limited amount on the earth's surface. Okay students, in the given picture you are observing the non-renewable sources and renewable energy sources. So these are the two most important types of resources. These are very, very essential for our day-to-day life. On the basis of origin, resources are classified into two types, biotic resources and abiotic resources. First, biotic resources. Resources which are obtained from biosphere and have a life are known as biotic resources. Students, all living things, all living resources are known as biotic resources. For example, birds, animals, fish, forests are the biotic resources. The biotic resources provide a variety of useful products to us. They have the capacity to reproduce and regenerate. Students, generally all biotic resources are renewable sources. Okay. Second type is abiotic resources. All non-living resources are known as abiotic resources. For example, land, water, mineral, etc. The abiotic resources are not renewable except water, which is inexhaustible. Students, these resources are in a great demand for the development of various industries and agriculture. Yes, students, we are observing non-living things are very essential for the development and the various for the development in each and every field, okay, in the infrastructure, in the agriculture, and in the other industries. These resources play a major role. Students, in the given picture, you are seeing the biotic and abiotic resources. Living things, plants, animals, bacteria, fungus, these are the biotic resources. And abiotic, water, soil, air, minerals, and light. So these are the most important two types of resources, biotic and abiotic. On the basis of occurrence, resources are classified into two types, natural resources and man-made resources. Okay, first, already we know that the natural things and man-made things. Okay, listen, resources available from nature in the form of water, mineral, forests, etc., and used by the human beings to satisfy their needs are known as natural resources. That means, towards those things we are observing in the nature, they are all called the natural resources. Students, many of these natural resources are essential for the survival of human beings and form the base for the development of a country. That means, students, we use these natural resources for fulfillment of our basic needs. So that's why, students, in our life, natural resources play a major role. Second type is man-made resources. Resources created by human beings to satisfy their needs are known as man-made resources. For example, roads, buildings, machines, etc. These resources are essential for us, but they are also developed from natural resources. Yes, definitely, students, we can take help the natural resources for the man-made resources. Students, the quality and quantity of the people of a country determine its human resource. Yes, so the people of country play a major role as a resource in the development of nation. So students, these are the most important types of resources, natural and man-made. Students, it's time to check your knowledge. Here are some important questions. You have to write the answer of these questions and read properly. I will take the revision of remaining portion of this lesson in the next online session. So, till then, thank you very much and have a nice day.